soon.
Yes, he is.
Amen to that.
Till he does. He's got us that way too. He's got us. He'll have us in. He's got us now. So there's no way we can lose you, Jesus. Anybody else? Someone can get a song for us. We might have a song out there.
How great thou art.
First and last.
Yeah, we'll do the first. We'll do the first and last verses of it. So that's not in your song book, unfortunately, but you know this. Let's worship the Lord. He is a great God.
Thank you.
Yes.
Let's do another one.
Yes, let's do it.
Amazing Grace, if we could.
Oh, yeah.
Amazing Grace is page 206 in the song. When you're turning page 206.
Thank you.
Did anybody else have a request? We can try one more request, maybe, if someone had. What'd you say, Mrs. Robinson?
I would like for you to pay for everyone in the nursing home.
We sure will, sister.
Amen.
Thank you, Miss B.
We're gonna do that here in just a little bit. I do want to, but thank you. I do want to say this. He loves us.
Yes, he does.
And he's called us to love each other.
Amen.
So I just pray that in Auburn, this place can be a beacon of light and love. As you all love each other, it's going to shine out. It's going to make a difference to all these people coming in and out of here that need Jesus. You know that? We need that love.
Amen.
Praise God. Praise God. There's a lot of good people here. There's a lot of work he wants to do here too. I will say this too. I was talking with a sister about a little situation going on here at the nursing home. This is what we call Pentecost Sunday. And what we celebrate on Pentecost Sunday is when the Holy Spirit came down and a mighty wind blew through, the Bible says. The reason I wanted to say that is this. Sometimes you're going to get opposition. You're going to have kind of a pushing against you. But I tell you what, the one in us, the wind blowing in us, is greater than the wind that's in the world that's out here. And any kind of trouble y'all are going through right now, our God is greater. His touch is greater than that. And I'm believing for y'all, whatever the battle is right now y'all are going through. Y'all are going to make it. Y'all are going to make it. Because I believe he is stronger. So hang in there. Hang in there. We talked about that today. He wants to take us and not leave us where we are, but take us further. It doesn't matter how old or how young we are. He wants to take you further. And he wants to help not only you, but somebody else that you're going to carry behind you all the way. Amen? All right. That was for free. That wasn't my message. That wasn't my message here. Stay, if you can stick around with us, we'd love for you to. We'd have a little gift for everybody. Our brother Woody picked out some awesome, sister Andy picked out some awesome gifts for us. So stay tuned. We'll be with you here in just a second. I do want to remind us of just something that's on my heart today to say too. We believe that, we talked about the Holy Spirit came down on Pentecost. You are never alone. Can I say that to you? You are not alone. And sometimes we wonder about where God is and something going on. And I just want to remind us we're never alone. In John chapter 14 and verse 18, Jesus said this, I will not leave you as orphans. I will come to you. You know who you is? Whoever's listening to this right now. You are that you. And as he doesn't leave us alone. He doesn't just kind of leave us out there and say, hey, I'll see you when I come get you in the rapture. He doesn't say that. He says, I'm going to come to you. And I believe he wants to do that for each of us here. He comes to us. And I met and I've talked with folks at another nursing home, and a lady, and she was a sweet little lady, and we had to pray together because she said, I can't see God. Where is God? I don't know where he is. And she was struggling with that. And so sometimes, even though we know Jesus, sometimes God feels far away. He does. He feels far away and we feel lonely. And there were times that I would go to the I'd be working, doing different things, and I would be pretty much alone. You know, there wasn't anybody really I could fellowship with there at that place. And I'd get me some Wendy's, maybe. I like Wendy's, if anybody's ever eaten there. And I'd get me some Wendy's, but I tell you what, it would just be so, you'd just be so lonesome you could cry. You ever heard that? Yeah, that's how I felt. Sometimes we feel lonely in those times. There's Elvis. Are you lonesome tonight? Since you got Elvis up in here. But I want to say this. When we get lonely, he comes to us. He doesn't leave us. The book of Revelation, all the way, the last book of the Bible, Jesus said this, behold, I stand at the door, and does anyone know what he's doing?
He's knocking.
He's knocking. If anyone hear my voice, I will come in. I'm going to eat some supper with him, the Bible says. He's looking to spend that time with all of us here. So my encouragement is, let's take that time to invite him in. So many times we feel so lonesome because we hadn't invited him in. We hadn't opened the door for him. May we open the door. Sometimes it does require we have to shut some other things out. Do you know that? We have to shut some things out. Maybe we have to turn off the TV for a while. Maybe we have to turn on a little better TV if that's possible. If y'all have phones and work on that, find something good on your phone. Read the Bible. Because I believe when we take even what seems like a small little thing for us, he can take and make something big, because you know what? He'll come. He will grace us with his presence. You know, God is everywhere. We believe he's all over this, but I believe he wants to show up for you and for me in a special way. He wants to show himself, manifest himself in what's happening. And I believe it doesn't matter where you are or when you are. He wants to touch that room right where you are, right here, even today where we are. He wants to bless us. And I'll say this too. He doesn't leave us alone even with other people. In the book of Psalms 68, verse 6, if we turn there and look at that, it says he sets the solitary in families. He sets the solitary in families. I believe he can provide those special people we need in our lives right now. So, I had a friend a few years ago. We'd basically almost grown up together. But he told me, I don't want anything else to do with you. That really hurt. It really hurt me. It was something that I had to struggle with. But something the Lord has had to show me, and I believe he'll show all of us. Maybe you've been in that place too. You don't have family you associate with. You've lost some folks over the years for one reason or another. But you know what? There's somebody else that he can provide for us. Somebody new, because he sets us in families. It might not be the same family we had before, but I tell you what, he has a family for us. And I believe in a lot of cases, it might be right here. He has a family for each of you. That's right. That's right. You might not see your biological family as much, but you have people right here that love you. Love you, yeah. Yeah, you have people that love you. And I tell you what, he wants to provide more for you and for friends. And so I know it's hard sometimes we feel alone, because during the time we went through COVID, you know, a lot of us were in that isolation, you know, when that the COVID came. And so coming out of that, it's been hard. I just want to say this. Let's be on the lookout and hold on to those people that the Lord Jesus gives us, and cling on to them and love them. And be open, because who knows, he might want to send us some new people into our lives to help and love and minister to us. He sets the solitary in families. The Bible also says this. Even if my father and my mother forsake me, the Lord will take me up. The Lord will take you. And never forget, he's got somebody for you in your life. You ever heard of a man named John Wesley? John Wesley founded the Methodist Church. He lived a long and hard life, but he preached the gospel. And he said this at the end of his life: the best of all is this, God is with us. He is Emmanuel. He is with you. When you feel alone and you feel lonely, he is still God with you. He is still present with you, ready to help and ready to be reached out to. And so I encourage us, if you're lonely, hang in there. I know I've been lonely in the past, and if you see him back, and she's in the corner there, but God gave me a wife and a helpmate to help me. And I want to say that he gives us people. He gives us himself. He gives us the very best. So Lord, help us to reach out if we're lonely today, because he wants to help us. And I'm thankful for us. And what he says here, right before he went up to heaven, remember this, Jesus said, "Lo, I am with you always, even to the end of time, even to the end of the world," he says. He's with you. He's with you. I want to pray for us here. Our sisters asked prayer for everybody in this nursing home. And I believe everybody in this nursing home, God has a plan for. Even some people that are giving us trouble, sister, God has a plan for them. Amen. There's deliverance that comes.
Yeah. And it's going to be totally different.
Remember, we don't serve a weak God. Amen. He is a strong God. And he is able to do. Whatever's going on, you know, we have spiritual battles sometimes, spiritual opponents, but our God is greater. The Holy Spirit in us, always, 100%, is greater. And so we grieve for that, that whatever trouble is going on here, he's got this.
Amen. Our love is the greatest gift God can ever give us.
That's right. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Amen. But anybody else with just an uplifted hand, say, "I have a need too." Maybe you just have any all over the place. There's needs all over. The reason I have you raise your hand is because you're not raising it for Nathan. My name's Nathan, by the way. You're not raising it for Nathan. You're saying, "God, help me." But sometimes the Bible says, "I lift up holy hands in prayer." And what we're saying is, "Lord, I need you. I need you." Can we just come and can you just pray for our crew here? Can we just pray for these here? The Lord will minister to them. I just encourage our crew. If anyone needs prayer, wave us down. If you you need a prayer before we leave here, we want to pray with you individually too. Because every one of these needs he cares about. Amen. Can I pray? Can we pray here for us?
Pray for our lost. I have lost loved ones.
Amen.
Yes.
Sister, I would be very glad to do that. I'll be very glad to do that. Can we pray now? Amen. Father God, I thank you that you care and you have a plan for everyone in this nursing home. And Lord, every man and every woman, everyone, dear God, is not beyond your reach. And we believe what you did on the day of Pentecost when you came down. Lord, you have that same power that you want to work through us in this place, Lord. And in the name of Jesus, we believe, dear God, that the mighty rushing wind come through this place, dear God. And Lord, you will be the great God, the loving God that you are for every person in this nursing home that needs a touch. Every hand that was raised, every one of them, Lord Jesus. Every one, dear God, you have something for them, dear God. You have something to minister to them. And Lord, I just pray in the name of Jesus that you reach down and that you touch these today. That, Lord, you give them ministry. That you meet them right where they are. If they're lonely in this place, Lord, just encourage them and let them know you're not going to leave them. And Lord, you have people here for them too. You have people. I pray your blessings. Lord, I believe you died on the cross so that we might be delivered, we might be healed, we might be saved. And if there's anyone that needs something today that's listening to this, I pray that they receive everything that they need. Oh, Jesus. We cry out to you and we believe for good in this place. And Lord, we love you for it. And thank you, Lord, that we're going to hear testimony soon, dear God, of overcoming in this nursing home. In this place, dear God, this is going to be a home, a habitation for you, Lord, we pray. And we love you for all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Can someone praise God? He's good.
Yes,
I
know you love God, brother dear. Tell him about it.
Amen. He's got this. That's right. Oh, yes, he does. Yes, he does.
We love you, brother.
We'll see if we can sing another good, fast song another kind of celebratory song. It is in the book if that's what y'all want to do.
Is that fast enough? What's another package? When we all get to heaven. You like that one? Is that in here?
Page 150 in your songbook, if you were going to sing this.
Let me verse. That's awesome.
Let's just sing the same couple. That's okay. I'm thankful for that day of rejoicing that's coming. And I want us to celebrate this right before we go here. We're going to sing the first and last verse of page 150. When we all get to heaven, when we all get to heaven.
Jesus today.
We love each and every one of you all and pray God's blessings. Lord, bless this group. Oh, in the name of Jesus, bless us, dear God, until we see each other again. We thank you for it. Hallelujah. So, we love you. We got something for you here. And if you need prayer, stop us. We want to pray for you, okay? God bless you richly. And for those on the internet, we love you. We'll see you soon in Christian life. God bless you.